Why'd you make so much soup?
It's for my family.
Soup for your family? Is that all?
Fuck around and find out.
Roll the fuck tape. What do you do when one of your loved ones gets the Rona? You make a giant fuck all batch of soup for them, that's what. Seriously, this is roughly a triple batch, so if you want to go smaller with yours, just divide everything here by three. Let's start out with our butternuts. These things are pretty tough to work with, and it's going to feel really disrespectful to your knife to cut them up, so make sure you give it a good honing when you're done. Trim off the ends and then carefully cut it in half. Now, a lot of people prefer to remove the rind with a knife, and that's totally acceptable if that's how you want to do it. This is the fast and easy way to do it. However, I like to use a Y peeler and... What the hell are you doing, Corn? You're super in the way. Oh well, you guys are here for him anyway, so enjoy this cat. Anyway, it's definitely more of a time-consuming method, but you won't accidentally discard any of the edible part in the process. Slice the bulbous part down the middle, and just like we did with our pumpkin for our pumpkin roll, scoop out all those seedy, stringy guts. Finally, roughly dice up the squish. The cuts don't need to be anywhere near perfect, so don't freak out if they're not pretty. Repeat this process two more times, then beg your knife for forgiveness. Our next course of action is to peel and dice two big-ass carrots. I'm gonna give my knife a break, so I'll use a high-powered assault Nerf gun instead. So I'll just take aim, and... No, that's not poor editing. The Nerf darts really are just that powerful. Now to do the same thing with two sweet potatoes. Peel and dice, or blam! This all looks a lot better in my head, okay? Again with the dicing. This time it's just two onions, though. These are a lot easier to cut, so I probably don't have to load the dart. Just... Wow, okay. That one actually didn't look half bad. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to start doing some actual cooking. Start by melting two sticks of butter in the largest stock pot you have. But launch pad, you say? That's only one stick. Well, you're right, but after I added some more stuff in and saw just how much I was actually cooking, I decided to add another one. So just start with two right off rip, okay? Add your onions first, and let them sweat a little bit. Kinda like when you got a bad report card and you were waiting for your dad to get home and find out. Too soon? Once the onions are in full-blown freakout mode, go ahead and add the carrots in to take the edge off. Stir it all together and let those cook in that buttery goodness for just a few minutes. Now that the carrots are starting to soften, throw in all the butternut and sweet potato chunks, and wow, that's a lot. Good thing you grabbed your big pot. Pour in about 3 quarts of chicken stock. If you're using store-bought like I am, make sure to buy stock and not broth, and go for the stuff that's low sodium. If you do this, you have more control over how salty the finished product is. Remember, you can always add, but you can't take out. Stir that shit up, cover that shit up, and bring that shit to a boil. Take a moment as it's heating to add a couple tablespoons each of chopped sage, chopped rosemary, and fresh minced ginger. Recover and cook for 20 to 30 minutes, or until all the vegetables are fork tender. Our last major step here is a vital one. Remove your soup from the burner and puree it using an immersion blender. If you don't have one of those, you can work in batches using a regular blender. Finally, salt to taste and add a healthy amount of fresh ground black pepper. Okay, a lot of black pepper. Fine, a metric ton of black pepper. I just really love black pepper, okay? Because I'm really bad at this, I forgot to actually film the finished product, so you're just gonna have to deal with this picture I took of it instead. At least it's panning. A lot of people like to finish their butternut squash soup off with a splash of heavy cream, and you could totally do that, but I opted to hit it with, some more black pepper. Don't judge me. Now go take this big pot of soup and feed all your loved ones with it. Enjoy! Let's go.